Special greetings, my dear students. Today, in a very short way, I am going to explain. Means we are just going to revise our second chapter, computer language. Okay, students, very easy. How many languages are there? Only four languages. Correct. First generation language, second generation language, third generation language, and fourth generation language. Correct. Now in this fourth generation language, first generation is what? Machine language, correct? First generation is a machine language. Okay. In this there is any translator? No, there is no any translator. Humans, we are translator. If you want to give any instruction to computer, we have to take a paper, we have to make our sum into binary form, and we have to type in the computer. Computer will give answer in a binary form. Again, we have to make that answer into a human format. Means we have to convert. Means a human computer. Okay, we have to convert into binary form, and we have to give to computer, and computer will give answer in a binary form, and this answer we have to convert into human language form. So there is no any translator. Only we are translator. No translator. There is no translator at all. Okay. And what is that language? Binary. Binary means what? 0 and 1. 0 means off. 1 means on. 0 means off, 1 means on. Okay. Now see second generation language. Second generation language name is what? Assembly language. We can say second generation is a assembly language. In machine language, everything is binary, only zeros and ones. But when you are coming to the assembly language, there is a one difference. Okay. We can use a mnemonic codes, means a nicknames. Some place we can use a symbol, some place we can use a some names. Okay, everywhere 0 1 1 0 0 0 1 1 0. So it is not possible for the human. So in assembly language we can use a mnemonic codes. This mnemonic codes will convert into binary form with help of what? Translator. Who is the translator? What is the translator programmer name? The translator program name is called assembler. Again, I am saying machine language, there is no translator, only binary values 0 and 1. 0 means off, 1 means on. If you are coming to the second generation language, we can say it is an assembly language, and there is an assembler. Okay, and assembler is a translator. And in this place, we are using 0 and 1 plus mnemonic codes. Okay, we are using 0 and 1 also, and we are using mnemonic codes. Means some place we are using symbols also. Okay, so this is the major difference between machine and assembly. Now, third generation. Students, these two, first generation, second generation, we can say low-level language. And third onwards we can say high level language. In third generation language, okay, high level language, we can say it is a high level language. And what is the advantage of this? It is very easier. Okay, it is easier, not very, it is easier. Means the example is what? C, C++, Java. We are using, means in binary there is no number called 5, there is no number, only 0 and 1. There is no number called 6 in binary. In binary there is no any number 5, 6, only 0 1, in assembly also. But in high level language it is easier, it is understandable for us. Okay, so if I want to say example, there are so many languages are there: C, C++, Java, Python, Ruby, Pascal, COBOL. So these are the languages or belongs to high level. Okay, in this high level there is a two translator programmer. Okay, two translator program is there. What is that means? One is a interpreter and second translator name is called compiler. Okay, so in a high level language, two translator, one is a interpreter and another one is a compiler. What is this interpreter? Okay, this interpreter will translate a program line by line. Now I written 10 lines program. Okay, I written 7 lines program. Okay, now interpreter program, I am interpreter program. Okay, now I am translating first line translated, I given to computer. After I will go to second line translating. So in this place there is one mistake. So what interpreter means, what I will do means, students, I am saying interpreter is not a person, it is a program. Okay, interpreter, this program, what it will do, it will stop here itself. Interpreter will not go to third line or fourth line or fifth line. Interpreter will not go anywhere, it will stop where, in this place itself, till, and it will tell in this line there is a some error, it will show there is a some error. So what we have to do, user, the person who is writing a program, they have to go and they have to make modify here, they have to change. If they correct this, if they make this correct only, interpreter will go to next line. In case in third line also one more error, so interpreter will stop. If there is any error, interpreter will stop in that place only, and interpreter will read, convert line by line. Okay, interpreter will convert line by line. Now compiler, what compiler will do? You make 1000 error, 2000 error, 1 lakh error, how much error you want, you make. Okay, you make how much error you want, you make. If it is an interpreter, the first error where it will stop there itself. When you are correcting that error, after only next it will read, interpreter. But in compiler, how much error you are doing, it no problem. Compiler will read everything. Compiler will read everything very clearly. 1000 line, 10,000 line, 20,000 line, how much line you are writing, you write. Compiler will read all program at a time, and it will show 10 error, 20 error. If you are doing 100, 200 error, it will show 100 error, 200 error, 300 error. Okay, but interpreter is not like that. Interpreter will stop beginning itself, but in compiler, second line error, third line error, and sixth line error, it will show like that. Okay, so this is the major difference between interpreter and compiler. And fourth generation, like humans, how we are talking. Okay, if I am going to some railway station, okay, some metro cities are there. If I go, some robot will be there. If I pay money, make coffee. If I say make coffee, it will make coffee for us. Okay, so this all are the, what to say, easy four level. It is fourth generation. This is very easier, like a human conversation only. But fifth generation is a artificial used in robots. But fourth generation is very easier, like simple conversation. So this is a simple explanation. Okay, and for your examination, only two chapters will come. Please kindly go through all the fill in the blanks MCQ, because fill in the blanks also will come in the form of MCQ. Okay, so thanks for watching. Be safe and secure.